Welcome back to more question, answer, happy, fun time, super happy answer, super happy, whoa, bush, super happy bush, fail bush, I'm mowing your bushes with my car. Okay, driving along, trying to stay on the road. Alright, so, carrying on, FergieSAFC123 asked what my favorite game is. That is a tough question. I'm going to go ahead and say... Well, my top three favorite games are Dwarf Fortress, Rome Total War, and IL2 Sturmovik. In no particular order. So, pick one of those three at random on any given day, and there you go. Alright. M. Weiss wanted to know if you will ever see me not crashing a plane in IL2. if you mean, will I do a Let's Play of it? I have really considered it, and I think it may be something that is in the cards down the road, but what I'd like to do with that is probably make some custom missions for it, because the laggy game is lagging. There we go. Alright, I'd like to make some custom missions for it, because the default single-player campaign is pretty freaking boring. So, yeah, maybe, but I imagine if I do that, you will also see me crashing. And he asks if I have any other gaming platforms besides my computer. And the answer to that is similar to the answer I gave to the what is that beeping noise sound. I consider my iPod Touch to be a gaming platform. Now, most people wouldn't, but I do consider it that. I use it for that a lot. There's a little side road here I can take. I'm going to take it. I don't see any warning minefield signs, so why not? Yes, I do use my iPod Touch as a... There's a rock there. I have to go around it. That's a really ineffective fence, guys. I've never heard of the old go-around-it tactic. Where'd my road go? Bad bush. Where is this road going? To another rock? No? Oh, here we go. I see. It sort of goes around... I don't know. I'm making a new road. Yes, my iPod Touch is sort of like a gaming platform for me. It can play some pretty intense games for the PSP and for the Nintendo DS and that kind of stuff. Where the hell? Oh, well. There, that was that beeping noise. That's my iPod. I just got an email. Or a message or something like that. I'm gonna go find that other road I was on. This one sucks. Tree attack. There's another dirt road there. Anyway, where was that one? So yeah, I consider my iPod Touch to be a gaming platform, and I really wish I could do... There's some pretty cool games for it. Really cool games for it. I'm not out of gas, am I? My car is just sucking right now. Go car. Alright, so, okay. Now, Eternal Zero asked if I will ever do a Let's Play of Freelancer. And... if I were to do a space game, it would either be of X3 or Freelancer, but I think I'll leave X3 to Plump Helmet Punk as much as I like it, because he's been doing a good job with that. And the other reason I like Freelancer is because it has a cockpit. See, like this, right here? You can see the car, you can see your hands, you can see the gauges, and they sort of work, and... oh no, we're going back into a town. It's gonna get all crazy. Anyway, I will talk in slow motion. Whoa! Did I just run over a child? I better keep going, quickly. Oh no, we're gonna get stuck. Settle down, game. I'm getting like 6 frames a second in fraps. Yeah, Freelancer is really cool. I didn't like Free Space as much because it didn't let you do the cockpit view. It was always just like, your face is the front of the spaceship, and I'm not cool with that. So maybe, but it's also a really hard game, and I'm not very good at it, like most of the games I play, so I guess that means maybe. I don't know, I haven't really thought about that one. It would be fun, though. Now, TurboTaunt, along with this question about what was up with all the peni, asked, what do I have in plan, what do I have planned for the Voltron army that I'm building of a community of Let's Players? Well, one day you'll see a video on my channel, and it will be called Let's Take Over the World with our Voltron Army. that'll be the easy part. But I don't know. I mean, I'd like to continue building this community here, and you know, like, I mean, I think it's really cool that we've got a lot of people with similar interests in similar games, who are funny and smart and like to interact and joke around and have a good time. The remarkably few trolls, with the exception of Cute Emo Boy and a few others. Oh, fuck it. I'm going off-road. I'm going treeing. I'm not going into that town. I'm just going this way. It's probably... where's my Variax compass? Oh, well. It's southwest. Wherever direction I'm going is southwest. So, yeah. I'd like to keep on building it into a community of fellow awesome people. He asked if I'd ever heard of the game called Heaven and Hearth. No, I have not. Now I have, so yes. Yes, I have. Imchim, tell us a secret you don't want people to know. This looks nice. Lakeside kind of bridge here. My brother, when I was born, my brother's 7 years older than I am. When I was born, my brother... Oh, no! Okay, we're good. I thought I drove it into a swamp. I don't want to have to walk all the way back to town and find another one. When I was 7, my brother... My mom and dad asked my brother what they should name me. And my brother... And this is... It's not what he said that bothers me. It's that my parents actually considered it. My brother said, "You should name him Jose for the sole purpose that I can say, 'No way, Jose.'" And they actually considered it. Actually considered it. And what sort of shows, webcomics, non-gaming entertainment do I watch / read? I read a lot of books. I read Chuck Palahniuk, Tom Robbins, McCormick McCarthy, Kurt Vonnegut, stuff like that. Robert Heinlein, even though he's dead. I read a few webcomics like XKCD and Three Panel Soul and Penny Arcade and stuff like, you know, your standard stuff. Three Panel Soul is not as well known as the other ones, but I really like him, and he's done a few Dwarf Fortress comics too, which is the sweetness. I like to watch TV shows. I liked the first 3 seasons of Battlestar Galactica a lot. I'm a fan of the show Entourage because it reminds me of my posse of friends when we were growing up and doing our road trip things. I mean, you know, we obviously weren't rich movie stars or anything like that, but the interactions that they have reminds me a lot of that, and so that's a show I really like. There's some really crappy shows that I like too, which I won't get into because they're crappy, but... The Ricky Gervais Show, which has just started on HBO, which is just an animation of his old podcasts. That one's awesome. That's one of the new shows that I'm really liking. There are more, but I can't think of them. Oh, yeah. The Pacific, Band of Brothers, Generation Kill. Those 3. Some of the best shows ever made. Okay. I like a lot of movies, too, but I won't get into that. That would take forever. We've only got 2 minutes left. So, Rarth... 359 asked, I can also answer... Oh, wait, never mind. Never mind, that wasn't a question. Leibowitz, how come you're so obsessed with numbers? I mean, there are like a bazillion number references. I'm not. I don't know shit about math. I just sort of, like, goof off with Wikipedia, and I'm like, what does this number mean? And it's like, it's a Harshad number, and I'm like, what the fuck is that? I'm not going towards that town. So, I'm amused by them, and my subscribers seem to enjoy that, and so I throw numbers at them. I'm horrible at math. Horrible, horrible, horrible. I had to learn the difference between the number 4 and the color brown. You know, like, I still get it confused sometimes. He wants to know if I'm a nerd fighter, and I don't know how to answer that. I'm assuming no. I don't fight a lot of nerds. Yashtod wants to know, why did the chicken cross the sky bridge? I heard a good chicken joke the other day, but I forgot what it was. I'm assuming because it was a chicken. I don't know. That's not funny. I don't know. Yashad also wants to know, who is Wenchy McBigtits? Is she into nerds? Wenchie McBigtits is a figment of my imagination, which makes it into far too many of my Let's Plays. It's just a funny name that I came up with on the spot one day. I was just like, Wenchie McBigtits. And I assume she's Scottish or Irish, because she's got the Mick part in her name, and so I don't mean that as a slur, but, you know, the MC part with the lowercase c. Anyway, I think her coat of arms would be absolutely hilarious. Alright, so pull over to the side of the road, and next time I will answer more questions. In fact, I think I'm going to leave this car for now. I'm going to go get a different car in the next one. Find a different road, and maybe make it so that it's not quite so laggy when I'm doing this. Okay, next time, more questions answered by me from you, and then we can carry on to the good stuff.